iOS 6 is a fantastic release. It has more than 200 new features, starting with some significant enhancements to Siri. I'll walk you through a few. Let's start with Siri. As you all know, Siri's only been out for 8 months and already does so much for you. You can send text messages, get all sorts of answers, set alarms, find out about the weather, make phone calls, create a reminder. For kids, or my kids, you can just chat with it for a while. Siri is fantastic. But in these 8 months, Siri has been studying up and learning a lot more. So let me just go ahead and show you what Siri can do now in iOS 6. So here I have a phone running iOS 6. The first thing that Siri has learned in the last 8 months is all about sports. So you can ask questions like, what was the score of the last Giants game?
The Giants were downed by the Rangers yesterday. The final score was 5-0.
So this looks great. We have this great scoreboard. I have to say I like the scores against Texas a little better during the World Series. But great sports scores ask of Siri. You can also ask about individual players like this. What is Buster Posey's batting average?
Buster Posey has a batting average of 290.
So you can see, you get player cards and player stats. It's very cool. You can also ask about standings. What are the National League standings?
Here are the standings for the National League.
So you can scroll down here, see the Giants there in second place. So Siri knows about baseball. Siri also knows about basketball. So I can ask, who is taller, LeBron or Kobe?
LeBron James appears to be slightly taller.
So you see his player cards. There's LeBron James, who is 6'8". If I scroll down to Kobe's card, 6'6". Now, it's not football season right now, but Siri also knows about football. So I can ask, when is the San Francisco 49ers' first game of the season?
The 49ers Packers game is September 9th, 2012, 1:15 p.m.
So the entire schedule right there is just awesome. So Siri knows about sports. Next up, Siri's learned a lot more about restaurants. So I can ask, find a great place for dinner.
I found 15 restaurants. 14 of them are fairly close to you. I've sorted them by rating.
So you can see we have a lot more information about restaurants now, the average price of a menu item, the type of restaurant. If I go ahead and choose one of these, I'll choose Millennium. You can see all sorts of information about the restaurant. We have maps here. We've partnered with Yelp. So you can see reviews right in here. Tap on that. And here's the reviews. And if you want even more information, just tap on any of these reviews and it'll take you right to the Yelp app from the App Store. I'll go back. We've also partnered with OpenTable. So I can tap here to make reservations. Takes me again to the OpenTable app right from the App Store. You can choose a date, number of people, and make a reservation. It's that easy. So Siri knows a lot about restaurants now. Next up, Siri's become something of a movie buff. So you can ask all sorts of questions like, what movies are playing at the Metreon?
Okay, I found 8 movies at the Metreon.
So I can tell you what movies are playing. I'll go ahead and choose one, Marvel's The Avengers. You see, we've integrated with Rotten Tomatoes, so you can see ratings and reviews. You can even tap to watch the trailer right here in Siri.
War has started. And we are hopelessly outgunned.
So really, really cool. You can also ask questions about directors or actors. So I can say, show me movies starring Scarlett Johansson.
I found several movies starring Scarlett Johansson.
So to find current movies in the theater as well as previous catalog. Just fantastic. Let me show you one more thing Siri's learned, and that is how to launch apps. So now, you've all been creating incredible apps, and now it's so easy to get to them. If you're like me, I have hundreds of apps on my phone. Let's say I want to play a game, I can just ask Siri now. Play Temple Run. And it's just like that. And those are just a few of the things that Siri has learned in iOS 6. So before, Siri did so much, but now it's just incredible. Sports scores, so you can ask for football scores or basketball, both pro and college. You ask about baseball, hockey, also soccer. And we do a lot of leagues, including the English Premier League. So sports scores. You can ask about movies. You can launch apps, make dinner reservations. You can now tweet just by talking to your phone. And there's this thing we're calling eyes-free. Now, you've heard of hands-free before. Hands-free allows you to keep your hands on the steering wheel while you use your phone. Well, we want to integrate Siri even better with the car. And so we're working with a number of car manufacturers to enable you to use a button right on the steering wheel to bring up Siri. Now, since Siri can talk back to you, you don't need, and we don't light up the screen of the iPhone, so you can keep your hands on the wheel and your eyes on the road and use Siri. Now, a number of auto manufacturers have already committed to delivering eyes-free Siri integration in the next 12 months. We are also taking Siri much more international. When we launched Siri, we launched it in English, in the United States, Great Britain, Australia, and we had French and German. Recently, we added Japanese. And now, in iOS 6, we're adding English and French tuned for Canada. We are adding Spanish, tuned for Spain, Mexico, and the United States. We are adding Italian. For Switzerland, we're adding Italian, French, and German. We're adding Korean. 60 countries represented here. We're adding Mandarin, tuned for Taiwan. Cantonese tuned for Hong Kong, and both Mandarin and Cantonese tuned for mainland China. Now, as part of making Siri more international, we're now taking local search, which was US only in iOS 5, around the world. You can now do local search even in China. And for the first time, we're taking Siri beyond the iPhone 4S, and we're bringing it to the new iPad. And these are just a few of the enhancements for Siri in iOS 6.